It's absolutely fantastic to have you here tonight. I guess the big question, what makes Kate Moss an undisputed icon?
Oh my goodness, I don't even know how you can begin to answer that question, but I mean, she's Kate, she's awesome. Like, it's been so funny looking on Twitter and Instagram today, like the pictures, everyone's just like honouring her birthday and all these just amazing pictures just keep coming up. Even like pictures of her like age 5, she just looks amazing. I don't know, you can't really sum it up, can you? She's just Kate Moss.
It is a very hard thing to describe, but what do you think the Kate Moss look is, and why do you think it changed the landscape of particularly British fashion so much?
I think she's got a very distinctive face. It's not your sort of standard pretty face. It's more angular and more striking than that. Like, she's got those amazing cheekbones and those wide eyes. And obviously she has like some kind of aura. It's not just about, you know, the big supermodels, it's never just about the way they look. It's about like the energy they give off, and she's obviously just cool, isn't she?
Looking around the current landscape, do you think there are any people who have that same kind of aura, that same kind of presence?
I mean, probably everyone will say this, but obviously Cara's kind of really, you know, she's again someone that sort of stepped out from all the other models, you know, who are all gorgeous, but she's obviously just got something a bit more. So who knows? I mean, obviously she's not Kate Moss's level yet, but she's doing amazingly, and she's obviously very, I think she could be iconic.
What do you think it is about Cara? I mean, like you say, she's someone who everyone keeps pointing to as potentially the next It Girl. What is it about her? Why does she stand out so much?
You want to look at pictures of her? She's interesting. She's captivating. And you know she's a cool girl. She's not, you know, she's not dead behind the eyes. Like, she brings something different to pictures. I will always, like, if I'm going through Vogue or something and I see her, I'll always stop and look. I think she's just, that's what she does. She's a brilliant model.
What are you up to yourself in the moment? What's coming up next for you?
I'm, well, just happily plodding along at MTV. I shouldn't say plodding, should I? I'm having a brilliant time and really focusing on that. And we'll be doing some festivals when they start kicking off this year. And I'm doing my fair share of modelling, and nothing in this league, but yeah, it's all good. Oh, and DJing, which I enjoy.
Woman of many talents. I mean, talking about modelling, of course, appropriate tonight. What's your experience of modelling been like? Because I think everyone has this perception, this sort of stereotypical image of what it means to be a model and what that life is like. What's it been like for you, though?
It's been an amazing experience. I've had some great opportunities. Had some shit times as well. It's just been I'm glad it's not my full-time job now. It was, and I've had some amazing times. There's been some real highs, but there's definitely been times where it's, you know, not been nearly as glamorous as people think. You know, being like holed up in some shitty model apartment in Milan, like isn't the glamour that the 15-year-old girls at home who are like desperate to be models think it is.
Of course, I mean, talking about the fashion industry, and I mean, people like Kate, there's always this intense debate about the fashion industry as role models aesthetically for women. I mean, what do you think about that? I mean, how well do you think the fashion industry deals with its responsibility when it comes to women's body image and the way it presents those aesthetic ideals?
Look, that's such a difficult question, isn't it? But I'd say, well, for example, the model agency I'm with, they're called Milk Management, and they really embrace kind of beauty of all sorts. It's not just about, you know, they've got plus size girls, and I'm not as skinny as they come, and they don't tell me to lose weight, you know. So that's the kind of modeling I like, where they're going to be like, this girl is beautiful, yes, maybe she's a bit shorter, or she, you know, has hips, but she still can really sell her products and look incredible on the page. So that's kind of more my thing. I don't like it when I hate hearing about people being made to lose weight or anything. That's not, I don't like that.
Ending on a positive note, going back to the festivals, is there anyone in particular you're looking forward to keeping your fingers crossed to see later this summer?
Oh my goodness. Well, I've never been to Glastonbury, so I would really love to go to that. But also, I went to Snowbombing Festival last year, which I loved. It's in Austria, up a mountain. It's like a skiing dance festival. It's awesome. So yeah, hopefully I'll be back there again with MTV.
Have you got wellies ready for Glasto? Have you got some nice flowery wellies?
Goodness, I have so many wellies.